So it's my great pleasure and honor to welcome our Vice Chancellor, Professor Laban Peter Ayiro, to make his remarks at this launch. Welcome, VC.
Yeah, thank you very much, Faith. I think our special guests, Shefas, Elle, and Bob, I have no words to express our deep gratitude as a university. I think I've had opportunity twice to engage with Elle and Bob, Shefas in their home. We have ridden in their tuk-tuk, the equivalent of a tuk-tuk. We have gone on his tractor, and we have argued, Alan, I think it was almost 2-3 hours in conceptualizing what this project, this support would, what form it would take. So I'll not give a speech, but I just want to share some thoughts that are on my mind. I think your work matters to God. No matter what you have been called to do. As you saw the Shefas, by any definition, they are ordinary folks. We have sat together in their home. They invested a lot in the land. They're staying like in the river on the outskirts of the cities. And now they have sacrificed that land for the needy people on this earth. So I'm saying we have Kenyans, me included, who perhaps have means to do what these two families have done. And for some of us, it is not too late. We are learning. So it's not the work that one has done. So when Christians understand and live out the biblical meaning of work, then lives, societies, and nations are truly transformed for Christ. And I think God, in designing work for us, intended that whatever we earn, the fruit we get from that work, should allow us to bring support to communities he has called us to serve. And this is what we are seeing today. So this is a very special moment. It is not a launch. To me, it is God allowing these two families to enable other families to flourish. So for me, fulfillment comes when we work hard every day at whatever God has put in front of us. And this is a manifestation of that. Even if what you're doing is not your dream job, and this is a lesson to those of us who God still has allowed us to breathe for another day. Fulfillment comes when we see the bigger picture of how our work combines with the work of others to bring about flourishing. So I want to thank the two families for allowing other human beings to flourish. But to do that, what am I seeing in these families? At least I can repeat this over and over. Elle and Bob are the meekest people I've met. And we know that if the Shefas were arrogant, why would they want to sell their land, their life savings, and give them away? I think they have overcome the human selfishness and have taken on the biblical antidote for pride, which is humility. And we know that the Bible describes humility very different from our shared culture. In Proverbs 3:5, gives an excellent summary of the Bible's teaching on humility. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. That is what I'm seeing today, the power of humility. Therefore, the Daystar community and those on the line today, online today, biblical humility must be seen as deep gratitude for God's sovereign rule over us that he created and his love for us. I think when you put on the apron of humility, like the shepherds or like the Mavenges, and you stand there and be able to identify with a cause and help human beings who are living in a broken world. And I have learned that biblical humility will help us guard against temptation to want to amass. As the Apostle Peter writes, be sober-minded, be watchful. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. And so as I finish, you have inspired us. You have inspired us immensely. And yes, the generosity of El and Bab will carry on forever in the hearts of us, the Daystarians. So thank you very much, and may God bless you, and may God protect you, and may we learn from the gestures that you have demonstrated today. Thank you, and God bless you.